Absolutely. You know, we only had a couple of days of practice last week just to stay sharp. And, you know, I got one of those days off there at the end of the week, and I've been going to treatment a lot, just trying to rest at my shoulder and get it back to what it was before the season even started. So I think going back to camp, we've been at it for about 20 days straight, those guys hitting, you know, at least twice a week. So it was good for their shoulders and good for their knees and all that kind of good stuff. So everybody was well rested and had a good practice last night. So we need to come back out on Tuesday and Wednesday and do the same thing. Well, you know, I've got a lot of phone calls wanting some tickets. So, and a bunch of the guys, they've been willing to give me their tickets for this game and let me borrow those. And that's much appreciated. And I think we're going to have a good turnout for the Trojan side up there.
What does that mean? What does this mean to you, being able to go back home? And, you know, all the stuff that goes along with going back there and playing for your family.
Well, it's huge. You know, I've been telling the guys all week, man, you know, we're going back to my home. You know, let's go up there and let's play hard, man. You know, these guys, they like to talk. And we can't let that get in anybody on our team's head. And, you know, it would be really, really good for me to go back home and get a win. I haven't won up there yet, even though I beat them my freshman year. It was at home, but I haven't won at Western yet. So it's going to be good to go back up there and see everybody, see my family, see all my friends from high school. So it'll be really fun.
Also, your connection with Western, with Brown, talk a little bit about that.
You know, he moved in with us in high school. He was my best receiver, obviously, in my high school. And he's just we've grown into basically brothers. He's lived with us, you know, still to this day, man. And I consider him, you know, one of my best friends, if not my best friend. And you know, he's just a really, really great guy and a good football player. And you know, I hope he has about 300 yards on us, you know. But I hope we win in the end. You know, I gotta hope he does well all the time. So. Their defense. You know, they're good, man. They're athletic. They've been the best in the conference over the past couple of years, defensive wise. So they've got some good players at linebacker, number four, and the free safety, number one, NFL prospects, apparently. So we got to go up there and play a good football game and know where those guys are at all times. But they're very beatable. We just got to go out there and execute and do what we do in practice. And that's, you know, play carefree and have fun out there like we used to when we were growing up.
We look after the Georgia State game and see that you snapped it 102 times. Whatever struggles you had in Georgia State, particularly early, it didn't seem like any of that was with the tempo. That's 102 snaps when you're really kind of not struggling with that. Is that possible every time?
Well, you know, it's tough because we only scored 35 points with 102 snaps, which means, you know, we were moving the ball well, controlling the clock, I would like to think. And, you know, we didn't put it in as much as we wanted to. We didn't get it in the end zone as much as we wanted to. But as far as moving the football, it hasn't been much of a problem. And if we can go up to Western and get 100 plays, that's definitely going to benefit us because it's going to keep it out of their hands.
Awesome.
Oh, yeah, it was a good bye week. We got a lot of good work in. Good start to Western Kentucky and things they do. You know, we got back to some of the things we do fundamentally, and I got a lot of guys resting up, getting well.
How about this defense and just the mindset? I know it was a struggle there in the season. Talk about the progress and just the mindset-wise when you guys are.
You know, we made a lot of progress. You know, we still giving up some things coverage-wise, but you know, it is what it is, but our mindset, you know, we're going in. We feel like we have a huge chance to win the conference, and we're going in. We're taking it one game at a time, starting with Western Kentucky.
Facing a back like Antonio Andrews, got it. Feel like Eric Thomas here, put up a lot of points. Mm-hmm. You know, what kind of game plan do you guys have to kind of shut him down?
We got to be able to tackle. We got to be able to get to the ball. You know, he's one of the top running backs in the country. And as a defense, you know, we're very excited to be able to face them. You know, we know they're going to run the ball with that pro-style offense. So, you know, we can't wait. It's a challenge.
Seeing what Lafayette was able to do there last Tuesday, coming into their, going into their place and taking care of business, so that, you know, riding a two-game winning streak.
Right.
Does that kind of give you guys a little momentum as well?
I mean, of course it did. You know, watching the game, the way we watched it, you know, we wasn't expecting the blowout like it was, but, you know, they can be beat, and that's what we want to go in and try to do the same thing. Oh yeah, it's a huge chance. You know, we won our first road game last week with Georgia, and you know, we haven't had much luck on the road, but beating a team like West Kentucky is a big statement. Oh, yes, sir. I've got a lot to improve on. To be honest, you know, I haven't really been satisfied with my season, you know, thinking about just the things that Mark Wilson wants to get better at. And, you know, those things that I have to get better at. And this game is going to be a big opportunity for me to improve.
Yeah, it actually couldn't have came better. I feel like we had a lot of people banged up. Gave us a good amount of rest so we can get ready for a big game.
Big game, of course, at Western Kentucky. You saw with Lafayette last week. That kind of, you guys are on a two-game winning streak here, feeling pretty good about yourselves. You saw what Lafayette went in there and did. Does that kind of help give you guys a little bit of momentum?
I mean, yes and no. Like, I watched the whole game, so it gave us a good, you know, and then we had practice, but it wasn't, like, we was getting ready for a game. So we got to watch the full game and basically look at things that we could do and things that we shouldn't do against them. But, I mean, we won. We got a good two games under our belt now. So, I mean, that's good. But just because Lafayette won doesn't mean that we're going to win. I mean, like, that we're better than them or anything. We still got to go in with the same mindset, play hard, and play the whole game, fight to win.
In the Georgia State game, when you rotated in and out so many guys along the front, you guys still had some gas in the tank at the very end. Last year, you didn't necessarily have that. How much of a difference does it make just having more guys and it's not, you know, just two, maybe three haven't played the whole game?
It makes a lot, a big difference, just because we had depth, but at the same time, we got experience too on the D-line. So, I mean, there isn't going to be a fall off from me coming out and John Clark coming in, or John Clark going out and Aaron Williams coming in. We all have faith in each other and trust that we know what to do and we're going to get the job done.
You got to think these guys are going to try to line up and be physical with you on the front with Andrews. I mean, that's where it looks like this defensive line is starting to kind of really play your best ball right now. Obviously, that's going to be a challenge.
Yeah, I don't know if a lot of people don't know, but we're real physical up front, so I kind of welcome that. So it's just going to who's more physical up front, and I seen that in the Lafayette game that their D-line ended up wearing down the O-line, and they were more physical through the course of the game, and that's what I feel like we have to do, be physical and continue throughout the whole game to get pressure and not just like for a half. So I feel like that. If we stop the run, I feel like we got a legitimate chance of winning the game.